Welcome to 2017's BFI London Film Festival. We are here at the opening gala for Breathe. It's an amazing film about love and overcoming disability. So let's go see who we can talk to. Well, thank you so much for joining us. First of all, what has inspired you to take on this film?
Well, first of all, it was exciting to be asked by Andy to score it. But I think it's a film about human resilience. It's a film that's very inspiring. It starts off as it's almost a classic kind of romantic fairy tale story, but then it descends into Robin Cavendish's personal hell, which is very powerful and very emotional to watch. And we really see how he and Diana together try through that level of adversity. So it's about building a vocabulary that reflects all of that.
So what was it like working with Jonathan and adapting his story? Because I imagine it must be quite difficult to kind of draw from his musical taste and yours, and then have the home videos putting a soundtrack to that. Can be like, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Jonathan's a really generous human being, as is Andy Serkis, but it was also very important to take into account all of his perspectives on his father's life and to really get input from him. So that happened a great deal. We talked it through, and sometimes even, you know, it was about talking about particular motifs and what they would have meant to perhaps Robin and what they meant to Jonathan. So yeah, that was very important to do that.
Well, this is Andy's directorial debut for a feature film anyway. What was it like working with him?
Andy's great. I mean, you know, like I said, I've worked with him for a long time. He's a really good human being, and he always, his heart is reflected in all of his work, and I think this is no exception to that.
And finally, what's it like? What does it mean to you to have your film open the London Film Festival this year?
It's an incredible privilege to score the opening film for the London Film Festival. That's amazing. So yeah, I'm really excited about it. But at the same time, I think this is a deserving film. It's a great film, and it's got some great performances from wonderful actors.
Well, thank you so much for talking to us, and enjoy the festival.
Read it from start to finish in one sitting and cried the entire time, and just so moved by her and it, and just loved it. There was nothing about it I thought was absolutely perfect in every single way. I think all of them have vulnerabilities, and all of them have strengths, and all of them have weaknesses, and all of them are strong and incredibly complex, and I think all women are. We all are. Come on. And so I am a woman, and so hopefully I'll continue to do that. I don't think I'll ever play a woman's role.
What do you admire the most about her?
Everything. Her whole being. I love her.
Thank you very much.
Well, these are real people. Imagine I'm writing a story about real people. And they're right there. And I'm making stuff up because I don't know what these two said. Have you seen the film? You've seen the film. But there's a lot about the experience of these people talking together very intimately. I don't know what they really said, so I have to make it up. And then I think, oh my God, they're going to be looking at me. They're going to say, I didn't say that. So, but luckily, it's worked out. And luckily, Diana Crucian, who's one of the characters played by Claire Foy, she's given it her blessing. She says it's okay. Although she does say, I didn't wear hats like that. So. From the script. But I'm very proud, of course. But it is. But I want to say, it's not my story. It's the real story of these real people. And they're crying and they're emotional because of what Robin and Diana did in reality, not because of me. So, I mean, I was crying too when I heard the story, and I thought, all I can do is not get in the way of the truth of this. If I can deliver a script that doesn't mess it up, then I'll have done my job.
Was working with Jonathan, I guess, was it helpful that you guys had such close in writing the script? Did he let you kind of like run wild, or were you kind of bouncing off the home videos?
The way it works, it happens usually with script writing. They let me do a whole draft, and then they make their comments, and then I have another draft, and they make the comments. Because you can't write constantly checking every word. You can't do that. So, yes, he did indeed let me run wild. And he just said, do whatever you want to do. So we worked from that basis. And then, of course, I would row back or I would put in the stuff or we would change something. Because it's not my story. I don't have the right to say, oh, I'm the author, it's got to be like this. You know, you can't do that. And I didn't want to. I wanted them to say, yes, this is real, this is true. And I cared about that more. Which is kind of lovely, you know, because the film business, it's a pretty nasty business a lot of the time with everybody's egos pushing and shoving all the time. And I said, look, this isn't about me, this is about them. So I'm just really grateful that we pulled it off.
How many amends do you have to do?
How many?
Amends.
Like drafts?
Yeah.
It's been 10 years. I started 10 years ago.
What does it mean for you to, for your film to be opening the film festival?
It's amazing. We never imagined that this would happen. It's only a small film. But do you know what? It's not a small film. It's gigantic. Because it's gigantic in its emotions. So it's great that we're here. Hope you all love it.
Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Irene from the Time Outlet. Very nice to have you here. So first of all, what is your part in it? And why did you choose to actually do it?
Okay, I play Dr. Khan, who works at the hospital where Andrew's character, when he gets the disease and comes back to the UK, and he's in the hospital where they're at landmines. And I'm the doctor that helps him to escape the hospital because he wants to move back home, wants to be with his wife, and he kind of assists that. And so it's a nice little funny subplot.
How much research do you do on poliomyelitis? You know, the polio, the disease. How much research do you do on that?
Well, I mean, it was so... We were in a hospital, and, I mean, it was a set. You had the iron lungs there, but they talked us through how they worked. And a lot of them were operational, you know, they were moving and they were working. I did do a little bit of research because I was playing a doctor who kind of specialised in that. But Andy was great as well because he talked us through it. It was quite a thorough audition process. You know, he wanted to kind of go through the scene quite a few times. We did lots of Skype sessions. So, there was a lot of kind of work done before we even got the set.
So when you say thorough auditions, how many did you have?
Five? Yeah. I mean, some of them were just chats with Andy, but yeah, and a phone call maybe. But it's all part of his process. He wants to get to know actors and make sure that he's working with people who he can trust to deliver the story. And because he's an actor himself, he understands how we work, and he wants to choose a cast that's just perfect for his film. So, yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
One question from
Hello.
Thank you. What is it that inspired you to pick up the script and actually work with this story? Because it is coming from real lives, real situations.
I think real stories are always fascinating, and biopics in general. I've personally always been fascinated by them, and seeing people, well, actors play real people, and having the opportunity. I know that my character did exist, and I spoke to the producer about it because it's his own story. So it's always great to have that reference point and be creative with it as well. You know, you can have a creative license to serve the story in the film, but it's always it's a wonderful opportunity to play a real person. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for opening the film festival and enjoy.
I'm okay.
Interesting. You know, I've never done anything like that before, so I found it very, very interesting and challenging and ultimately kind of fun.
What do you hope that people will take away from this film?
I hope that it inspires people to fight for their own lives in a way, to fight for their own, you know, to have as rich in lives as possible. I think that's what we're all here for. We're all here to fully live, you know, like the people protesting, you know, protesting for a living wage. That's the kind of thing that Robin was doing himself. He was protesting for a full life. He was petitioning and advocating for a full life. And that's the same thing that I saw happening tonight.
What's the quality you admire the most from your character, and why?
His sense of humour, his wit, his ability to laugh in the face of adversity.
How did you shoot this film?
Oh, right. with great difficulty. No, it was very, very difficult. I love that period of preparation and research. It's my favourite period because you get to steep yourself in a kind of circumstance that you're not familiar with. So I find that fascinating. It's like being at school, you know, with subjects that I'm very interested in.
How was it working with Andy Serkis on his directorial debut?
It was just wonderful. You know, he didn't feel like it was his directorial debut at all. It felt like he had been doing it for a long time. The second movie, you know, just kind of made it, put everyone together, created a real community. Thank you.
Bring your parents and story for big screen was too difficult.
Yeah, every day for about 2 years I did. I thought it was too difficult. Until I watched the finished film and I thought, okay, with all these amazing people, the best crew in the world, the best director in the world, and incredible actors, they've all made it work. And that was the first time that I thought we haven't made a mistake.
Thank you so much, thank you.
Okay.
It's amazing. I mean, it really is quite an honour and thrilled beyond belief. Not only because it's, you know, it is my directorial debut. The London Film Festival is a festival I've been coming to for years, and there's some great stories, great filmmakers show their work here. And the cinema, I've opened many great films with lots of extraordinary directors as an actor, and now to be here with me, with my own film, and to tell such a great story, which I think is a really valuable story and a story for our times.
This is a monumental film for yourself because it's a different film in general, and then also to open the film festival and also it being a real story. Was it really difficult to kind of have this task to take on?
The thing was, I'd already started to direct Jungle Book. So, and then this window of opportunity opened up to work with Andrew and Claire, and so we grabbed it, we got permission, and were able to shoot this movie very, very quickly. But it was just wonderful to be able to concentrate purely on performance, and unlike the other big movies that I've been working on where there's lots of visual effects involved, this is all about, you know, what's going on, you know, very in a very intimate way. And so that was an extraordinary privilege to work with the cast in that way was a real treat.
How did you characterize
their
work?
Sorry?
How did you characterize their work? Andrew Garfield and Claire?
They're an amazing couple. They're amazing people individually, but their combination, their chemistry was very rare. Do you see some people come together? I mean, it was wonderful to watch.
I don't want to just survive. I want to truly live.
Breathe.
So this is us wrapping up the London Film Festival opening gala with Breathe. Got a good couple of questions. A lot of great interviews, a lot of good shots, a lot of great people and cast crew, and a great film. So hopefully a good start to a film festival.